In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. My name is Engineer Ahmed Ragab, and I am a mechanical engineer, experienced construction manager with a demonstrated history of working in utilities industry, skilled in negotiation, team motivation, coaching, communication, and equipment maintenance. Today we will talk about the Caterpillar EUI fuel system, operation and troubleshooting. This presentation, part one, will show you EUI. What EUI means? Electronic unit injector. This system consists of two basic things. Number one, mechanically actuated by the camshaft operation, which push the forward to operate the injector plunger. Number two, it is electronically controlled by the ECM. What ECM refer to? Refer to electronic control module. In this presentation, we will know the principle of operation of the EUI system. This presentation will help the mechanics and operators, fresh engineers, or any workers in the heavy equipment section. Find this episode and information you gain good for you. May you subscribe in my channel.
Welcome to the introduction of basic operation and troubleshooting for the Caterpillar EUI fuel system. This presentation is a generalized introduction of the features, system operation, and troubleshooting basics for Caterpillar engines using the mechanically actuated, electronically controlled unit injector fuel system. This presentation is not intended to replace the Caterpillar service manual or other service publications. For detailed troubleshooting information, always refer to the latest diesel fuel systems. Use a plunger and barrel to pump high-pressure fuel into the combustion chamber. The cam lobes, push rods, and rocker arms mechanically actuate the injectors. The term EUI is actually an abbreviation for mechanically actuated, electronically controlled unit injector. Major parts of the injector include the tappet, plunger, barrel and body, nozzle assembly, and cartridge valve. The nozzle assembly consists of a nozzle spring, nozzle check, and nozzle tip. The cartridge valve consists of a solenoid, armature, poppet valve, and poppet spring. The injector is mounted in an injector bore in the cylinder head, which has an integral fuel supply passage. On older engines, the injector seated on a brass sleeve, which was swaged into the bottom of the injector bore. The brass sleeve provided a combustion seal and separated the injector from engine coolant in the water jacket. On 3406E engines, an improved stainless steel sleeve is used. This sleeve also separates the injector from engine coolant, but the injector actually does not touch the sleeve. Supply fuel is sealed above the sleeve by an external injector O-ring, and the cavity between the injector and sleeve is empty. The injector nozzle case seats directly on the cylinder head to provide a more positive combustion gas seal. The sleeve is installed with a light press fit and O-rings, rather than the mechanical swaging used on brass sleeves. Steel sleeve allows the use of internal threads. These threads make sleeve installation and removal much easier. C10, C12 engines also use a stainless steel sleeve similar to the 3406E. Rather than using O-rings, this sleeve fits in the cylinder head with a light press fit and is sealed using retaining compound on the upper and lower lands. Actuation refers to the type of force used to power the plunger, which pumps the fuel out of the injector. Mechanically actuated fuel systems use a camshaft lobe and rocker arm to provide that force. The rocker arm presses down on the tappet at the top of the injector. The tappet, in turn, presses down on below the plunger. Fuel displaced from the plunger cavity can flow in two directions. Fuel can flow to the nozzle assembly by that force. The rocker arm presses down on the tappet at the top of the injector. The tappet, in turn, presses down on the cavity below the plunger. Fuel displaced from the plunger cavity can flow in two directions. Fuel can flow to the nozzle assembly tip. However, to flow out of the tip, the injection pressure must reach about 5,000 psi in order to raise the nozzle check against the force of the nozzle spring. The fuel chooses the path of least resistance. It flows around the normally open poppet in the cartridge valve assembly to the fuel supply passage in the cylinder head. When injection is desired, the ECM sends a current to the solenoid on the cartridge valve. The current creates a magnetic field, causing the poppet to close. Fuel flow past the poppet is blocked through the plunger cavity to the nozzle check. When the pressure reaches approximately 5,000 psi, the force of the high-pressure fuel overcomes the spring tension holding the nozzle check closed. The check lifts off its seat and fuel flows out of the orifice holes in the nozzle tip. This is the start of injection. The rapid flow of fuel out of the plunger cavity is restricted by the very small orifice holes. Because of this restriction, injection pressure continues to rise very rapidly, even after the nozzle check opens and injection begins. Injection of the fuel leaving the plunger cavity. Depending on engine speed and fuel delivery, this pressure ranges from 10,000 to 30,000 psi. High injection pressures promote complete combustion and lower exhaust emissions. Pushing the fuel through the orifice holes in the nozzle tip causes the fuel to atomize into droplets in the combustion chamber. Fuel droplets burn from the outside into the center. Large droplets take longer to burn and may not have time to burn completely during a normal combustion cycle. Increasing the pressure of the fuel through the orifice holes creates smaller droplets. In turn, smaller droplets burn more completely. There are four stages in the operation of the EUI: pre-injection, injection, spill, and fill. The first stage, pre-injection, starts with the plunger and tappet at the top of their stroke. The plunger cavity is full of fuel, the poppet in the cartridge is open, and the nozzle check is closed. Fuel leaves the plunger cavity when the rocker arm pushes down on the tappet and plunger. Fuel blocked by the closed nozzle check flows past the open poppet to the fuel supply passage in the cylinder head. As long as the solenoid on the cartridge valve is not energized, the poppet remains open, and fuel from the plunger cavity continues flowing into the fuel supply passage. To start injection, the ECM sends a current to the solenoid on the cartridge valve. The solenoid creates a magnetic field which attracts the armature. When the solenoid is energized, the armature lifts the poppet until it contacts the poppet seat. Once the poppet closes, the flow path for the fuel leaving the plunger cavity is blocked. As fuel continues out of the plunger cavity, pressure builds very rapidly. The poppet transfers this pressure through the plunger cavity to the nozzle assembly. When fuel pressure reaches approximately 5,000 psi, the nozzle check lifts off its seat and fuel flows out the tip. This is the start of injection. Injection pressure continues to build very rapidly until the same volume of fuel pumping out of the plunger cavity sprays from the tip. Injection occurs as long as the plunger continues to move down and the energized solenoid holds the poppet closed. When it decides that injection should end, the ECM stops current flow to the solenoid. This collapses the magnetic field holding the poppet closed. Spring and flow forces open the poppet almost instantly. High-pressure fuel can now flow around the open poppet and into the fuel supply passage. With fuel injection pressures approaching 30,000 psi, the velocity of the fuel flowing around the poppet into the 100 psi fuel supply passage is very high. This results in a rapid drop in injection pressure. When injection pressure falls to about 3,500 psi, the nozzle check closes and injection stops. This is end of injection. The extremely fast pressure drop from peak injection to end of injection reduces particulate emissions and is an important benefit of EUI. Let's review the operation of the cartridge valve, which is the heart of the EUI injector. In order to perform correctly, this valve must be able to open and close almost instantly, seal injection pressures of 30,000 psi, and prevent leakage of high-pressure fuel during injection. Containing these elevated injection pressures without leakage requires extraordinary manufacturing precision and tolerances. Any high-pressure fuel leaking past the poppet during injection is not delivered into the combustion chamber. The poppet valve is not delivered into the combustion chamber. The poppet valve a million times during its normal wear life. The ability of the valve to function properly after hundreds of millions of cycles requires more than quality design and manufacturing. This level of durability requires proper fuel filtration to remove microscopic abrasive particles contained in the fuel. Abrasive particles smaller than 10 microns in diameter can cause accelerated wear in any high-pressure fuel system. That is why much finer filtration is being used on modern engines with high-pressure fuel systems. The difference between normal wear and excessive wear on a poppet valve seat illustrates the importance of proper filtration. On the left, you see a poppet valve seat with normal wear after extended use. Notice the condition of the sealing band on the poppet seat. While some wear is present from continued exposure to high-pressure fuel, the sealing band is still in good condition and providing a positive seal. The condition of the sealing band on the worn poppet is the result of abrasive damage from inadequate filtration. The damage to the sealing band is due to abrasive particles in the fuel flowing at high velocity past the poppet seat. This worn poppet seat leaks significantly during injection, resulting in low fuel delivery into the cylinder. In short, a prematurely worn injector. This condition can be avoided using proper filtration. Caterpillar offers high-efficiency fuel filters that meet the demands of newer high-pressure fuel systems and specifies the use of high-efficiency filters in many applications.